¿Qué es lo que mi gente? Yo soy Ricky de Bilingüe Vlogs. Gracias por estar aquí conmigo viendo otro video. I'm going to teach you guys how to learn Dominican Spanish. Manín, pero ¿qué es lo que contigo? ¿Por qué tú le quieres mentir a esa gente? Tú sabes que esos hablantes de inglés no van a poder hablar español como nosotros los velas de los dominicanos. Loco, pero ya te he dicho, yo no soy dominicano, yo soy como ellos. Tú siempre con la misma mentira, loco. Deja relajo. Pero que yo no estoy relajando. Yo te estoy montando la pura. Un día, manín, yo te voy a dar la galleta más fuerte del mundo por negativo. Loco, pero suéltame en banda. Ya no estamos en eso. Anyways, I'm going to teach you guys how to learn Dominican Spanish just how I did it, so that way you can confuse native speakers just like I do. And also, stick around until the very end because I have a secret weapon that I haven't shared with anyone on this channel about how to learn Dominican Spanish. So, let's get started. You guys, I read my YouTube comments all the time. I read my Instagram messages and I get this recurring message from a lot of different people.
Ricky, what are the Dominican Spanish resources that I can use to learn Spanish? I looked online and I can't find any.
The first thing that you have to do to learn Dominican Spanish is to actually be actively learning Spanish or already know Spanish, because Dominican Spanish is at its core Spanish. It's Spanish. It's the Spanish language with a few tweaks. The accent is different and the vernacular that they use is different, but it's still the same Spanish that people will speak all over the world. Now that we have that out of the way, what are the resources that you can use? In this video, I'm going to be breaking down the resources into categories. So first we have the YouTube channels. Then we have the TV shows and radio shows. Then we have the Instagrammers that you can follow, or the influencers that you can follow. And we have dictionaries that you can use and books that you can read to learn Dominican Spanish. Well, what are the best YouTube channels to learn Dominican Spanish? Well, obviously, Bilingüe Vlogs, this channel right here. If you're not subscribed, go ahead and subscribe to this channel. Porque a mí me encanta la cultura dominicana. Yo siempre estoy hablando como dominicano porque a mí me encanta ese acento. So, you can learn Dominican Spanish here. I have videos where I will break down Dominican Spanish words using the music that we listen to all the time. If you're not subscribed to this channel already, go ahead and subscribe. But besides me, there are other YouTube channels that you can actually listen to. The key word is listen to, because they're not really going to teach you per se, but they're going to be using their Dominican vernacular and they're going to be using the Dominican accent when they speak. And you can imitate that just like I did, to have the Dominican accent, and you can also learn new words and phrases. The first person that we have is Adolfo Lora. Adolfo Lora, he's a Dominican YouTuber. It's kind of a variety of videos that he has on his channel, so feel free to check him out. My favorite though, one of my favorites is this guy named Carlos Montesquieu. Carlos Montesquieu he's kind of a comedian, but it's crude humor. So if you can't handle crude humor, I wouldn't follow Carlos Montesquieu, because he just says whatever. If you want the complete opposite of Carlos Montesquieu, you have El Show de Carlos Duran. Carlos Duran, he's more of a pure comedian. He has, you know, clean humor. He will do trivia at the colleges. He sometimes will do social experiments. He likes to do verdad o reto whenever he reaches a new pinnacle in his YouTube career. El Show de Carlos Duran was one of my favorites when I first started learning Dominican Spanish. Next we have Quisqueya Life. Quisqueya Life, because the island of the Dominican Republic is called Quisqueya. Quisqueya Life, it kind of goes over the history of Dominican Spanish, and it sheds light on the fact that every single Dominican doesn't speak like a Dominican, quote unquote. You know, everybody thinks that they have this certain way of talking, and this guy has more of a neutral accent, and that's completely okay. You can speak neutral Spanish and still speak Dominican Spanish.
Espérate, ¿qué es lo que tú estás diciendo? Que nosotros hablamos mal.
Ahora tú estás de vuelta, ¿eh? Tú no me quieres dar banda.
¿Tú quieres hablar plepa de nosotros?
Yo no dije nada de malo, loco. Yo hablo como tú, ¿de qué tú estás hablando?
Yo hablo bien en castellano, tú tienes que saber. El español dominicano es lo mejor que hay.
The next two channels would be more of a BuzzFeed type of style, even though they're not from BuzzFeed. And that's Tres Pesos and Duct Tape. I love those two channels. They are always just talking about whatever they want to talk about. But it's more like, kind of like BuzzFeed style of conversation that they have going on there. There's another one too called Dominicanamente, but they haven't posted it in about 7 months. I don't know if they're still going to be active on their YouTube channel or what, but that is one that I liked. That's kind of like the same style as Tres Pesos and Duct Tape. Next we have somebody who they think that I look like. Hay pila de gente que me dice que me parezco a Dr. Natra. Yo no lo creo, pero what do you guys think? Do I look like el Dr. Natra? Or no? I don't know. I think maybe from certain angles. Anyways, he does the same thing as Alofoke on his own YouTube channel. Sometimes he even appears on Alofoke Radio Show, where they just talk to artists. But on his thing, on his channel, he has a few other things going on if you're interested in listening to him. Next, we have Capricornio TV. This guy has blown up a lot over the past year. So you know what he does is he goes to the Dominican hoods and interviews people. Sometimes it's sketches. I think it started off as being a real thing, but now everybody knows who he is, so it's kind of like sketches now, and it'll be putting artists on and things like that. But I will say that if you want to work on your Spanish comprehension from Dominican Spanish speakers, you need to follow Capricornio TV, because this guy speaks fast. Y hay muchos dominicanos que hablan muy rápido, mi gente. Tiene que saber. Follow Capricornio TV. You can just, you know, listen to a little bit and repeat, listen and repeat, listen and repeat. So that way your ear becomes accustomed to hearing how fast Dominican Spanish speakers can talk sometimes. Those are the YouTube channels, but now let's talk about things that you can listen to. Let's say you don't want to really watch something, but you want to listen to something when you're in the car or when you're running or working out, whatever you do when you just listen to something, but you can't really pay attention to the screen. First, we have one of the most influential personalities out of the Dominican Republic, Alofoke Radio Show. Alofoke Radio Show. He does have a YouTube channel too, but if you want to listen to his radio show, you can do that as well. Alofoke Radio Show. He's always interviewing the urban artists, the dembow artists. That's where I learned most of my slang from, honestly, because you're getting these urban artists that are speaking the way that they spoke in their neighborhoods. So check out Alofoke Radio Show. The next one that we have will be called El Mañanero. It used to be called El Mañanero con Boli. But anyways, El Mañanero, I used to listen to this every single morning before work. And this is more of a traditional radio show where they're just laughing the whole time, having fun the whole time, talking about things that are relevant, things that are going on. And sometimes they just have regular talks just to talk. And I love listening to El Mañanero still, even to this day. And I started to listen to them way back in, I think, 2015-ish. So El Mañanero is a really good show. So let's say you don't really care for radio and you don't really care for YouTube, but you more so just like watching TV. Well, there are TV shows you can watch, such as Boca de Piano Es Un Show. It's one of my favorite comedians. He's made movies like Sanky Panky, Los Dominriqueños, que es mi favorito. Yeah, Fausto Mata, he's over Boca de Piano Es Un Show, and it's just a variety show. It's a comedy show. I love comedy, so most of this stuff's gonna be comedy. Sorry, guys. But Boca de Piano Es Un Show, uno de mi favorito. Me encanta pila, mi gente. Raymond y Miguel, el show de Raymond y Miguel, también. I don't think they're still doing it, but you can find reruns, I'm sure, on TV or on YouTube or on the internet somewhere. You have Aquí Se Habla Español. Aquí Se Habla Español, it's just a show. You also have Más Roberto, De Extremo a Extremo. If you like news, Sin Noticias. If you like shows like America's Got Talent, you have Dominicana's Got Talent, Dominicana Tiene Talento. All these things you can watch. So like I said, the main thing is for you to listen to the accent and to pick out words and phrases that you don't know and try to define them. How are we gonna define these words? Well, stay tuned because I'm gonna share that with you in just a little bit, okay? I have a little bit more information to give you. Music can be a big driving force for people to learn Dominican Spanish. So if that's the case for you, if music has really inspired you to learn this, I wanna give you some artists that you can listen to. Of course, in the Dominican Republic, the top three genres of music are merengue, bachata, and dembow. You won't find a lot of Dominican slang in bachata. You will find a little bit more in merengue, but you will find the most and the most relevant in dembow music. So let me pass you the names of a few artists that I wrote down here. So we have Moza La Para. Moza La Para is the one that got me started in Dominican Spanish. I heard him freestyling and he is amazing at freestyling. I'm sure you might have heard of El Alfa El Jefe. El Alfa El Jefe, es un duro, tú sabes. La Insuperable, Roche RD, Kiko El Crazy. So, hay mucho más, mi gente. Hay pila de altita de dembow. Okay, there's a lot of artists that I didn't mention. I just wanted to give you a few, so enjoy that list. A part of life nowadays happens to be social media. There's Facebook, there's TikTok, there's Instagram. So I want to give you a few people that you can follow. You have El Pepe. You have La Psicópata. You have JD Con Su Flow. You have Jay Ramirez. Mike Tox. A Tu Edad Va a Seguir, Young Swagon, Then you have people like me. You have bilingüe. You have bilingüe blogs on Instagram and on TikTok as well as Estoy Aplatanao. And then there are other people who are native English speakers who love Dominican culture and love the Dominican language just as much as I do. But one of those guys is El Árabe, El Jefe, and then Tamara, the teacher. Ellos son de lo mío. So you can follow these accounts on Instagram or wherever you want to follow them if you want to surround yourself with more like-minded people. The last resource that I want to give you to actually like find words and to learn words would be books. So I was typing in popular Dominican authors, and it's been really hard for me to find books, like the kind of books that I like, but maybe you'll like them. I don't know, a lot of people are poets. A lot of stuff is about history, and maybe you will like that stuff. I like more of the fiction books. For example, the book that I'm reading right now is by this Dominican author, Juno Diaz, and his book is called La Maravillosa Vida Breve de Oscar Wilde. It's like, I'm loving that book because it's teaching me words that I already knew the words, but I never knew the origin of the words. So it kind of gives you like a historical part of the Dominican words or some parts of Dominican history, but it's still a fiction book, so it's still entertaining for me to read. So I would have to say that he's my favorite Dominican author. I'm really enjoying reading his books. One of the first books that I read by him was called Negocios. That was a pretty interesting book as well. But yeah, Juno Diaz is like the best one that I found so far, but I'm still looking for more. If you know more Dominican authors that you want to share, write those down in the comments below. But now let's talk about where we're going to look up the meanings of these words. 2 years ago, I wrote an article on my site, bilingueblogs.com, and the article was pretty much titled The Best Dictionaries for Learning Caribbean Spanish. So you can find the best dictionaries for Dominican Spanish, Puerto Rican Spanish, and Cuban Spanish in the same article. You can check it out up here. These are the sites that I used to understand what the Dominican words meant. The words that I learned from the YouTube channels, from the TV shows, from the books, from the Instagrammers. All these resources that I used to learn these words or to write these words down in my list, I found the definitions on these websites. That's the key. You have to be able to have somebody explain it to you unless you're going to use context clues, which is what I use nowadays. But at your level, it may be a different case and you may need to use these sites. And that's why I'm providing you with them now. And last but not least, here's my secret weapon right here. I've never shared this with anyone, but I have found this Diccionario de Dominicanismos, mi gente. And it is like the best. It is the best because it teaches you literally what words mean that are used all the time in Dominican Spanish. Now, the downside to it is that if you don't know Spanish, then it may be a little bit harder for you because it's written in Spanish. And also, the last revision was, I think, 2006, maybe 2012. I think it was 2006 or 2012, one of the two. So there are words that the Dembow artists are using nowadays that they didn't really use back then in 2006 and 2012. Por ejemplo, la pampara está prendida. La pampara está prendida that became popular, I think, in 2019. And nobody really used that phrase before. It really just means like it's lit. Before, we used to say está prendido or está prendida. Or la vaina está prendida, you know? But now it's la pampara está prendida. Or in vez de decir desacatado, now somebody can say trucho, andamos trucho.
Este tigre si habla español dominicano.
Ya lo sé, loco, ya lo sé. Yo soy tigre, tú tienes que saber.
Aplauso.
But yeah, so there are new words that you may not find in this Diccionario de Dominicanismos, but it's still a very relevant and powerful tool for those of you who are intermediate or more advanced in Spanish. So check that out. And that's all for today's video, guys. I hope that you've enjoyed this video. I'm going to be doing this for every version of Spanish, every dialect of Spanish. I just need your help figuring out which one I'm going to do next. So please let me know which one you want to see next. Whatever you guys tell me, I'll do it. But yeah, ya tú sabes. Hasta aquí el video de hoy. Y nos fuimos.